I'm going to briefly describe the temperature-entropy diagram that is an interactive simulation. The idea in this case is to help visualize what's represented in this diagram. When we show the diagram like this with lines of constant pressure, lines of constant enthalpy, lines of constant quality, and then a background grid, it can be confusing when you first look at it to understand what's being shown. And so what we've done in the simulation is give the option of unchecking a box and then those lines disappear. And so you can look at a less complicated view of the diagram and therefore get a better understanding of what it represents. And so the best way to see this is to look at the interactive simulation. So let's do that now. So here we're looking at the interactive simulation. And first let me remove the grid lines. They certainly are helpful for being able to read values off, but we're interested in understanding what the diagram represents. Let me temporarily add the phase envelope so we understand what part of the diagram we're showing: the saturated liquid line, saturated vapor, and then the critical point. And then let's step back and remove some of the lines. So on this phase envelope, let's put that back to make it easier. We're showing lines of constant quality with, of course, the saturated liquid being quality of 0, saturated vapor quality of 1, and then the mass fraction that corresponds to vapor is the quality. The enthalpy, constant enthalpy lines then show how enthalpy changes with temperature. And of course, on this diagram, when we're changing temperature, we're also changing pressure. We're keeping enthalpy constant on these lines. And so in the two-phase region, of course, we have significant changes in pressure as we change the temperature. And then here are the constant pressure lines, so we can see how as we move around the diagram the pressure changes. And the purpose then of the diagram and this simulation is to help you better understand diagram for various materials that are representing the phase behavior of, in this case, water, but certainly for other materials, similar diagrams exist, and you can read off values. In this case, the same kind of information that's available in the steam tables.